I have a story I'd like to share about a friend who came for the American dream. Instead, what he found was a nightmare. And now in his heart, there's an endless scream, and the pain inside doesn't ever stop.
My name is Carlos Arredondo. My son, last Corporal Alexander Arredondo, he served with the Marines in Iraq, two tours. On August 25, 2004, he lost his life fighting against the Mutara al-Sara insurgent in the old city of Najaf at the age of 20 years old. Alexander is number 974 killed in action. Alexander was very, very young. Alexander believed he went to Iraq because he was doing a humanitarian service.
A good friend of our family, who is also our neighbor, who developed a tumor in his face while he was in Iraq and came home, and his family has to pay a lot of money to go see him now in the hospitals that he's in, and they don't have a lot of money, so it's really hard for them to go see their son who has this tumor on his face, and the army is just not being helpful at all.
All the Iraqis who have been killed, what do we think of them? Do we give it a second thought that innocent children are walking around with, you know, with missing limbs, missing their limbs, one eye, you know, part of their mental capacity torn from them?
No! What do you want? Troops out! What do you want? No! What do you want? Troops out! What do you want? No! What do you want? Troops out! What do you want? No!
Alexander was just a boy, 17, when he signed up to serve. His father's permission was never asked. That took a lot of nerve. And it never would have been given either. Carlos saw through the lies. Iraq was not our enemy. It'd be nice if more were that wise. Alexander was underage, you see. Carlos never would have signed. His son was one of the Kleenex Marines that our government likes to mine.
And this is our generation. This is what we're growing up into. I would love to talk to them and say, do you really want me growing up into this? Like, do you want my future, my schoolmates, everybody, do you want them fighting in this in 10 years? Is this really what you want for the new generation?
So, you just came in today, is that right?
Yep.
How'd you get here, by car or bus? Or?
Bus.
What part of New York are you from?
Brooklyn.
Brooklyn. What part of Brooklyn?
Park Slope.
Park Slope. So, are you here with your parents, I guess?
Just him.
Just him?
It's my dad.
So I guess your dad's against... Is it against the war? Is your dad or?
Yeah, they're the ones who dragged me.
The labor movement was
oh, yeah?
So many
they're the protesters.
So they talked to you about it, I guess?
Yeah.
They saw something on TV or something? Or?
No, they've been talking about it since the beginning.
No, I heard from a friend, and then I saw a sign.
Oh, the march.
Larry Adams is going to come.
Yeah, how
he's
going to
speak. He's going to speak. He's
my
not
friend
there.
Told
he's
me
been
about
in
it.
A struggle. Give me a hand up to Larry Adams.
And he couldn't come. So I brought him, and I just looked online about it.
They shipped Alexander off to Iraq, more equipment for an illegal war, sent by our craven misleaders who deserve to be feathered and tarred. 2 years later, Alexander was dead, killed by a sniper shot to the head. On Carlos's birthday, a van drove up. Three men in uniform came to his door. They had news for him that was painful and grim. He wouldn't be seeing his son anymore. At first, when they told him those terrible words, it was impossible for him to believe. But it started to sink in slowly. He needed to think, to grieve. And the very first words that came from his lips were, "I'd like you to go. Please leave." And a half an hour later, they were still there, and Carlos watched them with a vacant stare. Then something inside him finally snapped and he headed for the van. He grabbed a hammer and started to smash. He'd become an insane man. What he was feeling can't be imagined, but pretend this had happened to you, that your precious son was killed by bloodthirsty fools. What do you think you'd do? Then he grabbed a jerry can filled with 5 gallons of gas. He was filled with an insane rage that would take a long time to pass. He doused the gas inside the van and found a torch nearby. Then Carlos pulled the trigger, and out shot the deadly flame. A powerful explosion resulted, and his life would never be the same. The blast blew him out of the side of the van. He became the dad on fire. And if his mother hadn't put out the flames, it would have been his funeral pie. Can you imagine this event in your life? Or maybe you would rather think these things couldn't happen to you. It's too painful to think about. While some of us are moved to action, we should all stand up and shout. Enough of this madness, this endless killing, this orgy of carnage, this criminal blood spilling. Enough, enough, and never again. We don't want to be ruled by bloodthirsty men.